Have you ever pondered the possibility of undiscovered treasures within the Grand Canyon? What may have happened to prompt the authorities to seal off this natural icon? Is it a mythical beast or the remnants of a long-vanished civilization? The Grand Canyon's closing a minute ago signaled the start of a mysterious adventure into the unknown. Are you up for the challenge of solving the puzzle? Because of a big finding made in the Grand Canyon, scientists and researchers have been left speechless, and their understanding of the natural world has been called into question. The shocking discovery was made by a group of geologists who were exploring the canyon when they came across a secret cave, buried deep within the canyon's rocky topography. They continued to explore further into the cavern, and as they did so, they came upon an astonishing variety of geological formations that contradicted the accepted theories. The most incredible discovery was a series of stalactites and stalagmites that appeared to be made of an entirely new mineral that had never been recorded in any geological database before. The preliminary investigation uncovered strange crystalline formations and chemical compositions that were unlike anything that had ever been observed before. The ramifications of this discovery have sent shockwaves through the scientific world, which has led to significant conjecture regarding its origins and the potential impacts it could have on our understanding of the geological makeup of the planet. This discovery prompted some fundamental concerns to be asked concerning the origin and development of the Grand Canyon itself. For many years, the formation of the canyon was thought to have been caused by the erosive strength of the Colorado River, which gradually eroded its way through the rocks over the course of millions of years. This once-in-a-lifetime discovery, on the other hand, called into question the accepted wisdom of the time and suggested the participation of more complicated geological processes that have not yet been fully explained. The Grand Canyon, which was already well known for its spectacular vistas and its relevance to the Earth's geological history, has recently emerged as the focal point of a scientific inquiry that has the potential to fundamentally alter our view of the history of our planet. As specialists from a variety of fields concentrate on the location, there is a better chance that a team effort between geologists, mineralogists, biologists, and any number of other scientists will be able to solve the secrets of this newly discovered cave and understand the cave's repercussions for the natural world as a whole. This extraordinary finding in the Grand Canyon serves as a potent reminder that there is still a great deal to be learned about the geological history of our planet and the processes that shape its landscapes. As exploration of this mysterious cavern continues, the entire world anticipates with bated breath the disclosure of other findings that have the potential to revolutionize our understanding of the natural processes that occur on our planet. The Grand Canyon is a spectacular natural wonder that stands as a witness to the powerful forces that have over the course of millions of years been responsible for shaping the Earth. This gorge is an astounding mile deep, 270 miles long and 18 miles wide, and it stretches majestically across the rough terrain. Its length is an absolute wonder, and its width is truly remarkable. The minds of countless tourists and researchers alike have been blown away by its bewitching combination of breathtaking grandeur and natural splendor. The history of Grand Canyon is a tapestry that is woven through more than 6 million years. The canyon was carved out over a huge expanse of time. An ancient story of geological development and changes in the surrounding environment is revealed in the exposed rock and sediment layers along the walls of this structure. The Colorado River, acting much like a paintbrush, has painstakingly scraped away at the layers, slowly shaping the spectacular masterpiece that can be seen today. If one could travel back in time, one would be able to observe the dynamic interaction of geological processes, such as how tectonic movements progressively raise the Colorado Plateau, preparing the ground for the unrelenting labor of the river. This awe-inspiring chasm that stretches across the southwestern United States was produced gradually but surely over the course of time by the forces of erosion, which worked in conjunction with the passage of time. A number of Native American tribes, some of whom have lived in that area for hundreds of years, attach a great deal of cultural and spiritual significance to the Grand Canyon, in addition to the geological significance that the canyon possesses. Their tales and customs contribute an additional layer of depth to the canyon's already rich history, creating a connection between the modern human soul and the distant past. Millions of people visit the Grand Canyon each year to be awestruck by its splendor and to feel a profound connection with the natural world. As a result, the Grand Canyon has become a treasured national landmark that is both protected and revered. It is a sobering reminder of the eternal processes that occur on our planet as well as the timeless beauty that is all around us. The Grand Canyon is not just a spectacular natural wonder that spans millions of years of geological history, but also a culturally significant site for many Native American and prehistoric human groups. The canyon's wide open space and varied topography have welcomed humans for centuries. Evidence of ancient human habitation in the Grand Canyon has been uncovered through archaeology. This habitation dates back thousands of years. These relics, which range from dispersed artifacts to abandoned settlements, shed light on the daily routines and cultural practices of the people who once lived there. Prehistoric societies flourished in this breathtaking setting, as evidenced by the discovery of stone tools, pottery shards, and rock art by archaeologists. For many Native American groups, the Grand Canyon is a place of profound spiritual significance. They have kept alive their cultural ties to the area for decades upon generations. The canyon holds significant spiritual and historical meaning for these indigenous communities, making it more than just a natural attraction. Through stories and rituals passed down through the centuries, they explain the close ties that their ancestors had with the land. The Havasupai, Hualapai, Navajo, Paiute, and Hopi are just some of the Native American tribes with deep roots in the Grand Canyon, and their viewpoints enrich the canyon's cultural fabric in their own ways. Their survival proves that indigenous societies can adapt to new circumstances and persevere in the face of adversity. Both the government and indigenous tribes are committed to doing everything they can to protect and celebrate this wealth of cultural history. Protecting archaeological sites and encouraging responsible tourism are continuous efforts to preserve the Grand Canyon's cultural legacy for future generations. Visitors and researchers alike can obtain a richer understanding of the profound and ongoing relationship between mankind and nature by immersing themselves in the rich history of this breathtaking landscape. G.E. Kincaid, a fearless explorer, set out on a unique trek into the enormous width of the Grand Canyon in 1909. At the time, he had no idea that this quest would lead to an astonishing discovery. An unforeseen turn of events would eventually reveal an old mystery that had been kept concealed inside the canyon's depths as he ventured farther and deeper into the treacherous landscape. Kincaid happened upon a hidden cavern while exploring the stunning scenery and craggy cliffs that the area is known for. This cavern had been hidden from the prying eyes of modern civilization for many years. He boldly entered the dimly illuminated hall, his heart pumping with eagerness as he looked around him in wonder at the attraction of its mystery allure. The cavern, much to his astonishment, showed a treasure trove of antique relics and exquisitely carved sculptures that were a witness to a civilization that had been forgotten by history for a very long time. The finding was nothing short of astounding in its magnitude and scope. The ability of the inhabitants who formerly lived in the depths of the canyon to create works of art was suggested by the delicate pottery that was decorated with elaborate patterns. Strong stone implements were left behind as mute witnesses to the routine activities of these mysterious ancient dwellers. The walls of the cavern were covered with enthralling pictographs that told stories of a time that had long since passed and was cloaked in myth and mystery. As Kincaid carefully examined the artifacts, feelings of reverence and duty began to permeate his body and mind. He was aware that this discovery held the potential to radically alter the course of history and offer a profound new perspective on the experience of those who came before us. He meticulously recorded his discoveries and made sure the items were well kept, so ensuring that future generations would be able to study and respect them. The discovery that G.E. Kincaid made in 1909 opened a door to the past, shedding light on the mysterious history of the Grand Canyon and providing a glimpse into the intricate tapestry that is human civilization. It is a living witness to the continuing power of ancient mysteries, which continue to attract and inspire people all around the world. It is also a testament to the enduring spirit of exploration. The team made a startling find as they gently wiped away dirt and time, a mystery statue with a face that looks eerily like Buddha's. This discovery prompted intriguing speculation on possible links between religious behaviors in different parts of the world. This, however, was only the first of many astounding discoveries they made. Copper tools were unearthed, several of which were decorated with sophisticated carvings and symbols that betrayed an advanced level of artistry. The researchers were amazed by the level of artistic skill and creativity demonstrated in these artifacts, and they wanted to understand more about the people who made them. However, the most puzzling discovery awaited them in an ancient tomb. The mummified bodies of people exceeding 9 feet tall were laid to rest there in a respectful hush. such a puzzling discovery called into question accepted narratives of human evolution, and experts debated the possibility of a long-lost race of giants or of variances in ancient human stature. The team of archaeologists was excited to continue their work at the ancient site in the hopes of discovering more buried chapters from the past and adding new dimensions to the chronicles of human history. Their innovative effort would inevitably influence future generations, altering our view of the ancient world and its legacy for the better. A mysterious underground metropolis, cloaked in enigma and steeped in history, was said to be buried deep under the Earth's crust. Only a handful of people were aware of its existence, and those who had experienced its marvels were under an obligation to keep quiet about them. This subterranean realm housed a treasure trove of various cultural relics that spanned centuries of human existence. Thus, the air within its winding tunnels was heavy with a sense of ancient awe. This was because the realm held a treasure trove of diverse cultural treasures. Every nook and cranny of the underground metropolis reverberated with tales of long-vanished civilizations. Ancient treasures from long-vanished empires were hung up on the walls, and they displayed the creative skill and technological sophistication of the people who had created them. The contrast of the many cultures left the guests in awe. For example, a delicate Ming vase was shown next to a powerful Viking shield, and a lovely Egyptian statue was displayed next to an intricately carved Mayan item. An ancient, mysterious metropolis existed beneath the earth. Those who saw it were sworn to secrecy. This subterranean realm had a rich wealth of various cultural items from centuries of human existence, filling its tortuous pathways with ancient awe. The underground city echoed ancient civilizations. Ancient treasures from lost empires displayed their creators' artistic and technological skills on the walls. A delicate Ming vase lay next to a sturdy Viking shield, while a lovely Egyptian statue stood next to an exquisitely carved Mayan treasure. Visitors were astonished. Despite its stunning splendor, this subterranean museum has a spooky feel. Soldiers in solemn attire guarded a forbidden ceremonial crypt deep beneath the city. The crypt was said to hold an unimaginable power that should never be released. Even the city's top authority didn't enter the vault. Any stupid enough to breach the city's sanctity was warned by generations of tales of what lay within. The forbidden crypt was tempting, but the city's citizens knew they had to keep the secrets. The underground city protected humanity's past and preserved the colorful tapestry of cultures that had previously flourished above. Cocaine and tobacco on ancient Egyptian mummies have prompted heated arguments among historians, archaeologists, and scientists, posing intriguing concerns about ancient transoceanic relations. These compounds were found in thousands-year-old mummified bodies, challenging accepted views about ancient civilizations' trading routes. Cocaine and cigarette stains on the mummies were initially doubted. Critics said such chemicals were native to the Americas and unknown to ancient Egyptians. The hypothesis proposes that ancient civilizations traded products and knowledge via secret marine or overland trade routes. The Smithsonian's role in these discoveries has been questioned. The Smithsonian has been accused of mishandling or hiding evidence, promoting conspiracy theories and mistrust. Some say the group suppressed facts that could challenge historical narratives. Despite the disagreement, these findings must be examined scientifically and objectively. Advanced analytical methods to detect trace compounds on mummies should be peer-reviewed to assure accuracy and dependability. Cocaine and tobacco in ancient Egyptian mummies urge historians and archaeologists to rethink past global linkages, regardless of the disagreements. It invites further study of cultures separated by enormous distances and seemingly insurmountable hurdles. More evidence may change our picture of past civilizations' intricacies, making human history richer and more interwoven. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel for more.